After implant, you may want to adjust stimulation settings or turn your stimulation on or off. Adjusting stimulation is easy using your combined patient programmer and recharger. You can use the programmer to turn your stimulator on or off, check the battery charging status, adjust your stimulation settings and select programming groups, and connect to the recharger cord in order to recharge the programmer. First, we will cover the basic programmer functions. To perform most of the functions on the programmer, you must first press the increase-decrease key to wake up the programmer. When the increase-decrease key is pressed to wake up the programmer, the unlock screen appears. Press and hold the lock button on the lock screen. Stop pressing the lock button when the screen changes to a circle of dots. This indicates that the programmer is searching for your neurostimulator and unlocking. Note, when the programmer is locked, you can still press the stimulation on-off key to bypass the unlock screen to turn stimulation on or off. Now let's walk through an overview of the therapy screen and what each button means. This is the battery status button. The left icon on this button displays the programmer battery level. The right icon displays your implanted neurostimulator battery level. Press this button to check the battery level. Here is the lock button. Press this button to lock your programmer after using. The menu button is on the top right of the screen. Press this button to access the menu screen. The group button is found here. Press to show the group name, indicated by A, B, or C. Green highlighting indicates the group is active. The group button will be gray when stimulation is off. An orange message will appear alerting you that stimulation is off. Next, let's go to your program buttons. In each group, A, B, or C, up to four programs will be available, indicated by numbered boxes. After pressing any of the program buttons on the home screen, available settings for that program will appear. This is the intensity icon. Intensity controls the strength of the stimulation. This is the stimulation icon. This turns your stimulation on or off. This is the adaptive stim icon. It turns adaptive stim on or off. These are the up-down buttons. You can press these to view additional stimulation settings for a program. The up-down buttons may or may not appear depending on how your clinician has programmed your neurostimulator. This is the rate button. This sets the speed of stimulation. This is the pulse width icon. Pulse width sets the length of the stimulation pulse, which affects the strength and coverage area of stimulation. This is the cycling icon. It turns stimulation on or off at regular intervals as programmed by your clinician. Adjusting your stimulation. To turn stimulation on or off for all programs within the same group, press the stimulation on or off button, which is located on the top of your programmer. Press unlock button if you wish to return to the home screen. The home screen will confirm whether stimulation is on or off. When stimulation is on, the active group will be highlighted in green. To adjust your stimulation settings, press a program button on the home screen. The available setting for the selected program will display. Use the increase-decrease keys to adjust desired program settings. You should be aware that some settings may not be available depending on what your clinician has programmed for your neurostimulator. Now let's talk about adaptive stimulation. When adaptive stim is turned on, the neurostimulator can automatically sense your body position and adjust the stimulation based on your position. The adaptive stim feature must be turned on to view or change adaptive stim settings. To turn adaptive stim on or off, press a program button on the home screen for the program you want to adjust. When you turn adaptive stim on or off for one program, it will be on or off for all the programs. You can make adjustments to adaptive stim to change intensity settings for a specific position. First, place your body in the position you would like to make adjustments to. Then, press the menu button and use the Check Position feature to confirm that the neurostimulator recognizes your body position, and then make appropriate adjustments to your intensity settings. You may need to stay in your current position for up to 5 minutes before the new intensity settings are felt. Your clinician can adjust this length of time, so you should confirm with your physician the length of time you will need. The next time you return to this position, the intensity settings automatically change to the newly recorded settings. Last, you might see some notifications pop up on your programmer. A red triangle with an exclamation point is a warning screen. Warning screens indicate a problem with the programmer, recharger, or neurostimulator. See pages 163 through 171 of the controller manual for more explanation of each warning screen. An orange triangle with an exclamation point is an alert screen. Alert screens indicate a pairing or other connection problem between the programmer, recharger, or neurostimulator. See pages 171 through 181 of the controller manual for more explanation of each alert screen. A blue circle with the letter I is a notification screen. Notification screens provide more information about stimulation settings, error conditions, and battery levels. See pages 181 through 186 of the controller manual for more explanation of each notification screen.